Okay. Hello, my name is Sakshi and today we'll learn about basic accounting terms. For any subject, we need to understand the terminology for it. So let's begin with the accounting terminology. The first term in this is financial transactions. What are financial transactions? In accounting, we only consider and we only record financial transactions. Transactions which are quantifiable, that means for which we can measure them in monetary terms and we can attach them some numbers. For example, bought furniture for business. Obviously, you bought the furniture, so you spend the money, so you'll have some amount to it and it's monetary in nature. Similarly, you sold something, for example, the building you were doing business with or probably the goods. Now, things which are very integral or very important for the business, which are not in monetary terms, we cannot assign numbers to it. Those are not included in the accounting terms. For example, any employee leaving the organization, any business which is very committed to fulfilling their commitments. These are very important for the business, yet we do not record it because we cannot assign numbers to it. Alright, now this was about financial transactions. We'll move on to the next term. Next term is the most important one, that is the asset. An asset is anything that adds value to the business and that is owned by the business. So the term own means that the business has bought it or it is in the name of the business. For example, computers. In today's age, obviously we buy computers, we use computers. So that is something which adds value to our business and is included in the assets. Car for the travel agency, if we are talking about, so the cars would be an asset to them. Similarly, the building in which we do the business, if it is owned by us, then only it is the asset. If we have it on the rent, then it's not the asset of the business because it is not bought by the business. So it is not owned by it. Similarly, office supplies, furniture and cash. That is the asset of the business. I hope that's clear. We'll move on to the next term, which is liability. Now, liability, as the name suggests, that you are liable to pay. So anything which you pay, which you are supposed to pay to someone, is your liability. It would include the word payable in the description. For example, I bought the goods, the business bought the goods for selling, but it does not have the money for now. So what they say, I will pay you later. So the business is liable to pay that amount of money for which he bought the goods, and then it becomes the liability of the business. Okay, now let's move on to the next one, which is the capital. Capital is again the liability of the business, but it's towards the owner of business. Now, why we have kept a separate term for the liability towards the owner? Because it identifies that it is towards the owner, and the liability in general is the liability towards the third parties. For example, when the business is started by the owner brings in capital in it, investment. So we keep a separate head for it. We say it's the capital of the business. And the business is liable towards the owner with such an equal amount. Okay, now we'll move ahead with the next term, which is drawings. Drawings is the amount or the goods which are taken by the owner for his personal use. And that is the reason if the owner's capital separate from the liability, because we have different transaction which affects the owner's equity. Capital and equity is the same. So it affects the owner's capital. It reduces the owner's investment. So drawings are the amount or goods withdrawn by the owner for their personal use. Now we'll move ahead with the next one, which is revenue. Now revenue That is the goal of the business. You started the business to get revenue, to sell your assets, sell your goods or services. For example, Amazon is in the business of selling goods. Google, on the other hand, sells the services, that is the software. So amount which you receive for selling the goods or services which the business deals in gives the revenue. Similarly, the expense would be amount you spend in order to produce those goods and services. For example, payment of rent for the premises you have taken, rent of the office, or the salaries you pay to the employees, or the electricity bill, telephone bill, internet bill, those all comes in under the expenses. That was all about the basic accounting terms. Thank you for watching the video.